Look who's on the line, the former Bulls power forward and the Bulls color analyst, Stacey King. Hey, Stace, how are you?
What's going on, DP?
The poll question, you can have Shaq or Kobe for their career.
Whoa, man, that's a tough one. I heard this discussion. In today's NBA, I got to go with Kobe. In 90s, I'm taking Shaq all day. But in today's NBA, I'm taking Kobe.
But if I look at today, there's no good big men. Who's going to defend Shaq?
Yeah, that's a good point. But you can neutralize Shaq in this league. I think it's harder to guard a Kobe Bryant with the way the rules are set up. And he's just, think about this way the game's played now. The big man is a dinosaur. They're extinct. I mean, everybody's shooting threes. Would you really want Shaquille O'Neal out there shooting threes? I don't think so.
Oh, no. No. We don't want that.
Yeah, exactly. And in the free throw situation, I mean, that'd be tough, too. And I love Shaq. I mean, I hope Shaq's not listening to it. I don't want him to get choked out. He's going to have to tap out or something. But, Shaq's my boy. So, I don't want to harden any hard feelings. But in today's NBA, I got to go with Kobe.
Explain this to me about...
You can build around Kobe in this day's NBA. You could get a big man that can hit pick and pops. You can build around him a lot easier, I think, than you could with Shaquille.
Explain to me why Shaq couldn't shoot free throws.
I think his hand's too big. It's just like a guy, you telling the guy to get up to the free throw line with these big hands and shoot a softball into the net. Like when you go to the carnival and then the ball's too big and they expect you to make the free throw with the big ball and it doesn't go in, they try to trick you to say it fits and it doesn't really fit. That's kind of like Shaq.
You got a favorite Kobe Bryant story?
You know, I never played with Kobe. I just heard a lot of stories about him. He's the closest thing to, we were talking about this last night, he's the closest thing that we've seen in this generation to Michael Jordan. You've heard all these guys, they dubbed all these guys, the next Jordan, the next Jordan, the next Jordan. There's probably been about 30 of those guys, but he's legitimately the closest thing to Michael Jordan as far as the mannerisms, the competitiveness. He's even punched teammates, in practice. So that's kind of about they're even, but that's about the closest. He's about the closest thing. I don't think you'll ever see another player like that, like Kobe. It's a dying breed. And he's the reason why I was saying I would build a team around him now, because of his fire and his, he plays and his competitive nature. You watch the games now, you don't have rivalries. You don't have like these killers. Everybody's friends. Like, hey, what are we going to do after the game tonight? Kobe wasn't like that. Michael Jordan wasn't like that. They were killers. They'd pull your heart out and watch you let it beat. And so you don't see that now. You missed that in this game.
Stace, good to talk to you. Congrats on the Bulls' success this season. Kind of a surprise. We appreciate you joining us.
Hey, we're going for 7 in a row, baby. We're going to the playoffs.
Thank you. That's it. Stacey King. Calm down, Stace. Stacey King, a former Bulls power forward and color analyst. Easy there.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.